Hello guys, Emil here. I'm making a quick tutorial today on how to get started using Pangolin Quickshow and Pangolin FB Fork. So here we have a really basic setup, and this is just a quick and dirty tutorial on how to start using your system. So for this you will need a laptop or a PC running Windows with an Ethernet port. So here, since mine doesn't have one, I have a small dongle external. You'll need an Ethernet cable, can be any kind, it's just standard Ethernet, and a laser equipped with Pangolin FB4 counts. The power, the brand, doesn't matter. This is a small ECS beam box, but it could be a Kavan, could be Arctos, could be anything. As long as it has an FB4 inside, it's going to be the same way to set it up. The first thing you want to do is go and grab the latest version of Quickshow out of Pangolin websites. For this, you go to pangolin.com, go to support, go to download, and here you have a couple versions of Quickshow. For us, we will need the full version 4.0 for this setup, but you have the option to download a demo version of the software, which allows you to play with it without any laser output, and you have a custom version of it for Windows XP people that would still run these or low-powered PC, so it's a simplified version of it. But for us, it's the full version. While this is downloading, we can already start ahead and put power to the system. You'll see that straight away, the green LED on the FB4 will light up, which means it's getting power and it's ready to be plugged. So we can go ahead, take our Ethernet cable, go from laser system to our machine here. And you will see that straight away we have the orange LED that lights up, which means there is no communication between the FB4 and the network adapter on here, the laptop. This allows to check. If this would not light up, that means you have a cable problem between the two. So, a couple of things we can do. We can, if you press on the encoder wheel, you can see it turns on the screen, and we can go to operation mode and check that we are in beyond quick show mode. FB4 offers a lot of different ways to be operated, including ArtNet, DMX, autoplay, can also have timecode, and other things like that. But for us, for today, we need to go in beyond quick show. And we can also go to network setup and stay in auto IP. So the PC is right now set with auto IP and the laser is auto IP. So the two of them will sort the IP by themselves. We don't need to go out there and do anything special. So while waiting for the couple of seconds left for downloading, the quick answer to why FB4 is so much more user-friendly than the classic FB3 that we had, you know, before, which would go USB to ILDA, is that we can skip completely these cables. Like, this is only one Ethernet cable. It's really easy. It's really cheap. Like, running 100 meters of this gonna cost you less than the difference in this that setup if you had 100 meters of ILDA cable. And still, you can daisy chain as many lasers as you want. ILDA will, all the lasers will do the same. With an FB4 inside, each laser is individual and independent, so you can do whatever you want with each. And that's the really big thing. So with this, if you would say, oh, I want three lasers, and I want three lasers to do three different things, you would need three counts, three long runs of ILDA cables with all the problems that comes with them, because they are like fish hooks. They're attached to everything. They're fragile. They are quite expensive. The connectors are fragile. This, you would go to a show, oh, you forgot your cable, can go to any electronic store and buy another run of Ethernet cable if no one has it on site. Good luck finding one of these, you know, when you're somewhere in the middle of nowhere. So once download is finished, we can go ahead and close the Internet Explorer and start installation. Let's go ahead and let's put this in English. Accept agreements and installation starts. it does take a little bit of time, depending on how powerful your PC, but there is a lot built in already in QuickShow. So the point is, with that setup, you could really go straight from taking the laser out of the box, like I just did here, and installing the software and directly going on a show. So that's really convenient. Pangolin already provides you with a lot of graphics and atmospherical effects cues built in the software straight away. So that means you can, you know, start playing instantly. As soon as you get your laser, you're ready to go on your first show. And over time, you will create your own content and add more to it. But that makes it really user-friendly. I would also like to point out that, as you did see, I just went to Pangolin's website to download the software. So you can install the software on many PCs as you want. Even if you have one laser, you can install it on 10 PCs, as long as the one, you know, if you, when you want to open the software, you have the laser connected. That's, you know, the key of it. Pretty much DFB4 would be the dongle that allows the software to run. But still, the installation is free. It's free to download. And you can do as many of them as you wish to go. So it's almost complete now. Just wait a couple more seconds. So you can see we do all of this in one single shot. So you can see how fast it is to set up the whole system. And we're ready. Up. Let's launch QuickShow. You will see that straight away, the red LED starts to light up on the FB4 in the back, which means now the FB4 is communicating with QuickShow. And it's loading the workspace. And now it's ready to go. You will see on the lower part here, you have a little icon that's blue and blinking. That means the software is connected. You can see it's named Projector 1 because we only have one unit. If we had multiple connected now, you will see multiple projectors side by side. And that's the power of FB4, is that you can connect us up to 9 units on QuickShow, and you can go up to 40 on Beyond. And you can go straight away from one to the other. I will show a bit in another video. I will show a little setup with multiple units and see how it looks like. So once you're in QuickShow, you can go ahead and go to Parameter and Quick Setup. Here we have a couple text box that opens, and we go ahead, and the first one is to select the user level we expect. I will always recommend to go Expert. The others just remove some functionality, but QuickShow is so easy to use and so straightforward, there is really no point into removing anything from it. So we can go ahead and go Expert. Then it's scan speed, and that depends on your laser. But by these days, if you have a unit that's equipped with an FB4, it's going to be most likely equipped with scanner that at least are able to do 30,000 points per second, which is the case here. It's an RGB system. And we can go ahead and use analog, because it's also modular. You can go all colors. TTL would only be 7 colors, so it's on or off for each color. Analog allows you to do all the fades in between each tint. And we're ready to go. So we can then just select any cue and press enable laser output, and we have laser output. QuickShow is split in two when it comes from Pangolin. So you have one part is graphics, which is more what you would project on something like it is right now, and the other part is atmospherics, which would more be what you would use with haze and atmospherical effects. And so you can just scroll and find out, you know, what you like, what you want to use, and get started. The last thing I want to show before this is over, you can go to Projector Parameter, and you have this window that opens. Here I have one projector only, so it's showing here. And when I select it, you can see I can change the zone it's scanning and the size of it. You can go ahead and click Test Pattern, and output the first one. And this just allows you to visualize the area, and you can select here the brightness that is showing. So you can reduce if you don't want to go to your audience. You can go overhead, make sure this doesn't touch anyone. You can select the size either here or on the scrollers here. And make sure you know you save with your areas, scanning areas. There you go. You're ready to go. Have a good day.